What's going on, YouTube? It's your boy Silverback June. I'm out here back at it again with another video. You know what I'm saying? You see the mask, you see the gloves. I'm out here, you know what I'm saying? Keeping it safe, keeping it pure, keeping it 100. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, today's episode really is going to be on. Let me take this mask down, you know what I'm saying? Because I'm actually by myself. So today's episode really going to be about is a oil pressure switch. Not oil pressure switch, but an oil pressure gauge. You know, very important to have on your car. You know what I'm saying? It's a nice little mod too for you to do on your car, on your vehicle. You know what I'm saying? Oil pressure gauge is exactly what is labeled pressure. So an oil pressure gauge is basically, it tells you the pressure that the oil is pushing out on your pump or whatever. So you see if the oil is low, or if the oil is too low, you know you got a problem in your motor. But if the oil pressure is just right, you know you can always keep an eye on that. A lot of people put pods and stuff like that with the gauge on there. You know what I'm saying? They have water temperature, they have the oil pressure gauge, and they have a temperature gauge. Some of these old school cars, they didn't have that, so they used to put pods and all that stuff. But I'm gonna give you a rundown, you know what I'm saying? So this is kind of the tools what you need. This is the pod right here, you know what I'm saying? I got a glow shift. Like I said, I got this from Jada Fixer. I customized this myself. This is my pillar right here for the corner, all right? And these are kind of the tools you're gonna need. So I got my test light. I got a test light over here. I got my oil filter. This doesn't come with the kit. I got this from Jada Fixer too. This is called the sandwich plate. You need that. And I got a couple of little gadgets here so I could use my wires and stuff like that. Also have Teflon tape, you know, for the sensor. The oil pressure gauge, it does come with a little sensor like this. So keep in mind, you know, so I got my oil ready. I got some Pennzoil 5W20. That's what the Hemi requires. You know, I'm going to do an oil change at the same time. I use Mopar filters. You know what I'm saying? I got my wires over here and I got my tools. Of course, you need a jack stand. You know what I'm saying? And that's pretty much it. You know what I mean? So I'm going to get into this video. Give me a few seconds to get set up and I'm going to show you what I'm doing. You know what I'm saying? Silverback June. Stay tuned.
A few moments later.
All right, so one of the first things you want to do, you want to drain the oil, all right? So I got my pan down there. I got my socket ready, 13 millimeter. I'm getting ready to drain the oil, and then I'm gonna take the oil filter out and show you where the sandwich plate comes into play, all right? All right. Let the oil drain, and you let it sit in there. You let all of it come out until everything is out. All right? Let it come out, all the oil. Let all that oil come out. I'll be right back. All right, so let me explain what I'm doing here. So this is the sending unit sensor for the oil pressure gauge. It has a G. It has a WK and it has a G. The WK goes to ground and the G goes to the sending unit. That's going to be the wire that goes to the pod. So this pod in here, the green wire on the pod, this green wire, the G. This green wire is going to go here. And I made a wire already. I made a wire already to attach here. Boom. To go in this one, and then I just lock it in place, right? This is gonna go inside the car, right? This is gonna go on the sandwich. This is a sandwich plate. So basically, the sandwich plate this sensor is going to go into the sandwich plate. Anywhere, it has like 1, 2, 3, has like 4 holes. So any one of these holes, I could place this sensor in. But I still have to wire it up. You understand? So. Oh, thank you. I'm sorry. Thank you. So basically, I'm going to, this right here, boom. So put this in here, boom. The sandwich plate goes up where the oil filter rests at, and that's it. You put the nut for the oil filter, the nut right here, the sandwich plate, the oil filter right here goes in this, and that's it. And what I'm doing right now is just wiring up the wires so I can get it ready. And then I'm going to show you what I'm going to do after that. All right, peace. All right, y'all. So now I got my sandwich plate together. You see the sensor right there? It's already connected. I got my ground wired up. I just got to now run the wire to the sending unit for the pod. And that's it. Right now, put my oil filter in there. My oil filter sits in here like so. Okay, hold on 1 second. Oil filter in there. Twist it on there. That's it, man. My oil filter's in. You know what I'm saying? And all I gotta do now is run my pod, my pod wires to the inside of the car. Oil change is already done. Drain plug is already in. All right. So now I could drop the car down and start wiring it up from the inside of the car. All right. I'll get back to you on that one. All right. Now, here's where the fun starts, right? I got my key in here. All right. You see the oil light right there? Matter of fact, my bad. You see the oil light right there? Boom. That's just an oil light, an indicator. This right here is a gauge, okay? So when I start my car, after I wire all this up, the gauge moves and it tells me the pressure, where my oil pressure is at. You know what I mean? And it's very simple to wire. And I'm going to use the radio wires to get the wires that I need to get this thing to work. So let me give you a rundown of what these wires is about. Remember, you have the green wire. The green wire is for the signal. Okay? Signal for the sensor. Then you have ground. Okay? You have the yellow and the red wire. The yellow wire is constant power. And the red wire is ignition power. Ignition, like when you turn your car on and off, you want this thing to come on and come off. This one, power is always on. It's always constant, always 12 volts. So you're going to see this here. The orange one, you don't really got to worry about. You can set this up on your light, whatever this case that, the third, whatever. So I'm going to take the bezel out on this right here on my radio. I'm going to use the test light, my test light, and see what wires is what, so I could get all the wires that I need to wire this up. All right? And I'm going to get back to you. I'm going to show you what I'm talking about.
Hey, bro.
What?
Oh, my God!
All right. So I got my test light right here. This is my test light. I got my radio out, my bezel, everything. So now I'm looking for constant power. Remember I told you that yellow wire is constant power. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put my test light in here. And once this thing lights up, bam. You see that? That's constant power. My ignition is not on. My key is not in there. So I know this wire, I could run that yellow wire. I could run that yellow wire too. Okay? That's one. Now I got to find ignition wire. Ignition wire is the wire that when I turn on and off the car, that, you know, with the key, you know, the car will shut off. So I already know where the yellow wire is. Okay. Now I'm going to look for that. I'm going to look for that that ignition wire. Look for that ignition wire now, which is the red wire. Normally, 9 out of 10 times, it's the red wire. So I'm gonna look for the red wire here. Okay. I think it's this one over here, but don't quote me on that. All right. So I'm gonna tap into this blue wire, right? This blue wire right here. This blue wire should be my ignition wire. You see the red where I tapped into the red at? This wire I ran to the cigarette lighter for whatever reason. My thing wasn't working one time and whatever. So I'm going to tap into this one and I'm going to see if this wire is the ignition wire. So right now the key is off. I'm going to turn my ignition on and I'm going to check that wire. See that? That light is on with the ignition. Now, when I shut this key off, this light should go out. See that? The light is out. So I know this blue wire, red wire is the ignition wire. So I could run that red wire to this one. No problem. Ground. I could run my ground right here on this bolt right here. Any one of these bolts. This is metal. Anything metal right here, anything metal is ground. Okay? So I got ground, I got constant, and I have the ignition. And I have the ignition, right? And the signal wire, basically, my signal wire is right here, this green wire. That's going to run directly to that green wire, and I'm good to go. That's it. Simple as that. All right, I'm going to get back to you.
1 hour later.
Silverback June, man. Back at it again, man. This is the end of the video, man. I hope you like it. Like, share, subscribe to my channel, man. The oil pressure gauge is done. Let me give you an idea of what it looks like. You know what I'm saying? Woohoo! Game changer! You know what I'm saying? That's how you install an oil pressure gauge on a 5.7 Hemi, man. I've seen a lot of videos where, you know, I seen it on a Mustang, I seen it on a couple of Subarus and all that stuff. But it's very self-explanatory, man. You know what I'm saying? So, like I said, once you know the wiring and everything like that, you know, everything else is just pretty much a go. You know what I'm saying?
I could get you satisfied.
Damn, you know what I'm saying? Coming along, right? Yeah, but like, share, subscribe to my channel, man. I'm about to button this up, man. Like, you know what I'm saying? It's all done over here. I'm just chilling out right now, lamping out. I'm about to relax, go chill out, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, man, this is the end of the video. You know, like I hope, like I said, like, share, subscribe to my channel. You know what I mean? And you know what I'm saying? Do it yourself. Do it yourself. I'm bringing you do it yourself content. You know what I'm saying? So these are things, little things that you can do on your own. You know what I'm saying? Where you make your car look nice. You know what I'm saying? And looking fabulous. You know what I'm saying? When you come inside, you know. You know what I'm saying? Come inside your car, man. Your car looking legendary. You know what I'm saying? And you know, like I said, man, a lot of little content, do it yourself videos, I'm bringing to you. You know what I'm saying? Silverback June, man. I'm out. Be safe out there. Peace.
Right foot slide. Basically, I'm saying either way, we about to slide. Hey, can't let this one slide. Hey. 2C slide, then I hit it double time, then I hit a spin, cause we spun that block a couple times. If it's not the right time, it'll always be another time. I'm not even tripping, we'll just see them in the summertime. Whoa, yeah. Can't describe the pressure I be putting on myself. Yeah. Really, I just can't afford to lose nobody else. Yeah. If they move a shaky, we'll just do the self. If I move a shaky, Chelsea do the himself. Yeah. Solo, don't eat YOLO for real. Heard a lot about you, but we don't know for real. Next time, guarantee the truth will get revealed. Black leather glove, no sequins. Yeah, buckles on.